Students, today, continuity of the lesson, the age of empires, Gupta and Vardhanas. Now, let's discuss about the topic is art and architecture. The Guptas were the first to construct temple, which evolved from the earlier traditional of rock cut. These temples were dedicated to all Hindu deities. The most noticeable rock cut caves are found at Ujjain and Ellora, Maharashtra, and Udaygiri in Odisha. The structure of temple built during this period resemble the characteristic features of other divided styles. Two remarkable explain of Gupta material sculpture are first one a copper images of Buddha about 18 feet height at Nalanda, and second one Buddha 7 feet in height. The most important example of the Gupta paintings are found on the rocks of the Ajanta caves and the cave in Jaintiades. Next one, literature. Through the language spoken by the people was Prakrit. The Guptas made Sanskrit the official language and all their epigraphic records are in Sanskrit. The Gupta period also saw the development of Sanskrit grammar based on the grammar of Panini and Patanjali, who wrote Astadai and Mahabhashya respectively. A Buddhist scholar for Bengal, Chandragomia, composed a book on grammar titled Chandravya Karanam. Kalidasa's famous dramas were Sakuntala, Malavikagnimitra, and Vikrama Urvashyam. Other significant works of Kalidasa were Meghadutta, Raghuvamsa, Kumara Sambhava, and Ritu Samhara. Mathematics, astronomy, and medicine. Innovation of zero and the concrete evolution of the decimal system were the legacy of Guptas to the modern world. Aryabhatta, Varahamihira, and Brahmagupta were famous astronomers and mathematics of the time. Aryabhatta in this book Surya Siddhanta explained the true causes of solar and lunar eclipses. He was the first Indian astronomer to declare that the earth revolves around its own axis. Dhanvantri was the famous scholar in the field of medicine. He was a scriptures in Ayurveda. Charaka was a medical scientist. Sushruta was the first Indian to explain the process of surgery. Vardhana dynasty. The founder of the Vardhana or Pushyaputri dynasty ruled from Thanishwar, Pushpati served as a military general under the Guptas and ruled to power after the fall of the Guptas. With the assistance of Prabhakaravardhana, the Pushpati family became strong and powerful. Rajavardhana, the eldest son of Prabhakaravardhana, ascended the throne after his father's death. Rajavardhana's sister, Rajyashri's husband, Raja of Connage, was killed by the Gowda ruler Kashanka of Bengal. Kashanka also impressed Rajyashri. Rajavardhana, in the process of retrieving his sister, was treacherously killed by Kashanka. This resulted in his younger brother Harshavardhana became king of Taneshwar. The noticeable of the Kanish kingdom also invited Harsha to take its crown. After becoming the ruler of the both Taneshwar and Kanage, Harsha shifted his capital from Taneshwar to Kanage. Conquest of Harshavardhana. The most popular king of the Vardhana dynasty was Harshavardhana. Harsha ruled from 41 years. His territories included those of Jalandhar, Kashmir, Nepal, and Valabi. Sasanka of Bengal remained hostile to him. It was Harsha who unified most of northern India, but the extension of his authority in the south of checked by Chalukya king Pulikesan II. The kingdom of Harsha disintegrated rapidly into small state after his death in 648 AD. He maintained a cordial relationship with his rulers of Iran and China. Next one, administration. The emperor was assisted by a council of ministers. The prime minister occupied the most important position in the council of ministers. Baha, Haryana and Bali were the three kings of text collected during Harsha region. Criminal law was more severe than that of the Gupta age. Perfect law and order prevalent throughout the empire. Harsha paid great attention to discipline and strength of the army. Harsha built institution for the study of the traveler and to care for the sick and the poor. Religious policy. Harsha was the worshipper of Shiva in the beginning, but the emperor's Buddhism under the influence of his sister Rajyashri and the Buddhist monk and traveler Hian Shang. he belonged to Mahayana school of thought. Harsha treated Vedic scholars and Buddhist monk alike and distribute charities equally to them. He was the last Buddhist sovereign in India. As a pious Buddhist, Harsha stopped the killing of animals for food. He was noted for his policy of religious toleration and used to worship the images of Buddha, Shiva and Sun simultaneously. He summoned two Buddhist assemblies, one at Panaj and another at Prayag, art and literature. Harsha, himself a poet and dramatist, gathered around him a best of poets and artists. Harsha's popular works are Ratnavalli, Nahananda and Priyadarshika. His royal court was adorned by Banabatta, Mayura, Hardatta and Jayasena. Temples and monasteries functioned as central of learning. Kanauj became a famous city. Harsha constructed a large number of viharas, monasteries and stupas on the bank of the Ganges. The Nalanda University, a university and monastery combined, was said to have had 10,000 students and monks in residence. When Hyanshang visited the university, let's recap of the lesson. Sri Gupta was the founder of the Gupta dynasty. Chandragupta I, Samudragupta and Chandragupta II were the great kings of Gupta dynasty. Vishnugupta was the last recognized king of Gupta Empire. Divine right theory of kingship was practiced by the Gupta ruler. The Guptas were the first to construct temple, which evolved from the earlier tradition of rock cut Srinis. Harsha was the prominent ruler of Vardhana dynasties and was elevated to the position of an empire. Harsha was a great artist and dramatist and constructible to the development of literature and art. Harsha, though a strong follower at Buddhism, also promoted Vedic religion. Next, we will see book pack exercise.